able to sit there and charge forever.
Yeah, so we're getting into game number one. I really feel like this is kind of an easy matchup. Something that I really want to show people is look how many times they're going to be falling with aerials. Yoshi's always going to be usually falling with the Nair, and Ike's always usually going to be falling, you know, with the Nair.
Oh, we're starting off on Smash Roll. You know, I'm a big fan of the stage. I really like this for both these players. A nice, compact, tight, intimate stage for both people to be.
I feel like Yoshi really likes the stage just because he's able to kill a lot earlier because at the really low percent, if you get hit with a down air, that's what, instantly 33%, 35%, right. And then more combos. But that's where the Nair into forward air comes out.
Mm-hmm. Oh, got the first egg roll of the set.
Egg roll's a sleeper move. You could use it. It gets people off guard and then, you know, free damage.
I love the way that Ike's standing kind of at that distance where Yoshi has to jump over and commit. And every time he runs forward, Ike is just like kind of just jumping back and then doing these Nairs just to catch the approach. Because we saw a dash grab and a neutral B both get punished by the fact that Ike just short hop backwards.
Something that I really want people to see is whenever Ike is doing an unsafe aerial with like a Nair, Yoshi's always going to be Nairing out of shield. That's such a huge move from Yoshi just because A, it gets him off, B, that's already in disadvantage, right?
Oh my god, that was a scary air dodge. Dynamite was scouting that out. It looked like he had that up smash ready, but just not pulling the trigger on it.
You see the eggs come out, trying to create some more space. But this is the really scary part. Dynamite's trying to get in, but...
Yeah, well, why not?
Yeah, just dash attack, baby.
I guess hit by that falling back here.
That's what you said before, right? When Ike's trying to side B or up B, it's just an easy forward air at that point.
Yeah, bro. If you're confident you got it like that, absolutely go out there. That's just a free stock.
I would say the person who's going to be winning this game would be somebody who's in center stage the whole time, just because both characters' approach options very, very limited. Yeah, Yoshi has
that spacing.
Well, Yoshi has a Nair, but it's just so hard trying to run in there against somebody who's, you know, down tilting you, forward airing you, and especially spacing out with Nair.
I love this. Yeah, I love the spacing that Ike's doing. He's really just getting right outside the range where Yoshi wants to be, and he's just always punishing him.
Look at that forward air just catching the double jump. It's really hard to just go straight to ledge as Yoshi with his double jump. So he's always going to get hit with the forward air. He's going to get hit with the Nair up air. But we see Ike in disadvantage
right now. Oh, big catch.
Ooh. Yoshi steals games. This character, super good.
As soon as that jab happened, I think everyone was out there thinking it. But retaliates right back with that Nair up air. One stock apiece. Dynamo was looking really struggling on that percent. Ike was just outspacing him at every point, but he got that one opening and capitalized on it.
Yeah,
that's really that good mark.
Yoshi steals games. Like, every single time you're off stage with a Nair or with a jab, they're always going to go out with some sort of up air or forward air to try to spike you, and especially trying to get you with that that tech chase with their jabs. Mm. Jab, jab, run up, jab more, and then, you know, F smash.
Yeah, and I think what you were saying before this matchup started, like how bad this sword is. Wait, hold on, we got a jab lock.
Yeah, that's right. What I've been telling you about.
F smash, are we going out there? We're just holding it. He tried to do the F smash. Oh, almost down to that Nair back air.
Air dodge?
I love that every time Dynamite has gotten like these one hits, he's converted so well off of it. He might not get a hit for 40 seconds. That second he does, man, look what happens.
Super, super explosive character right now.
Oh, this could be it.
Forward air? Oh, I didn't think he was going for another command grab. That's a very interesting option. But what is Ike Tyson going to get after that?
That move is super hard to DI at high percent. It sends you so far up at like this awkward like angle. It will explode you. That was such a good game. Like, Ike was doing really well a lot of that time in that mid percent. He was outspacing every time Dynamite tried to go in. But like I said, every time he did get that one hit, it was automatically, I'm getting my percent in. We saw it there. He got jabbed at 30 off smashable platform and immediately got fared.
I would say the biggest thing in this matchup is that Ike wins the neutral really hard if he has center stage, because Yoshi can't really do anything to get in. Maybe he's going to throw an egg one or two times, but overall, Ike just swinging with the forward air really, really good. That being said, once Dynamite gets the opening, that's just, you know, instant death usually.
Oh, we all go in Northern Cave.
North Cave's legal. How do you feel about this stage?
When I heard that this stage was coming and but Kalos was leaving, I was a big excited. Wait a minute! Catch him again? Okay.
Oh, I was going to say, that's a really good command grab. It looks so weird, but, you know, command grabs in the air.
Oh, gets another really up air? All right, back it up on him. But to answer your question, I do like this stage over Kalos. I haven't seen too much of this stage specifically, but it seems like a lot of people are enjoying this stage, so I think it's just a good sign. Oh, I love that air dodge up.
That's something I haven't seen a lot of Yoshis do. A lot of Yoshis and a lot of people that have tether grabs, really, really scared to commit to it, but trying to tech chase in the air.
I like that down air time. He was definitely going to die there. See, double jumps out of the combo. Sometimes if you're not really susceptible with it, you're going to die. Calls him out there with that up smash. He knows that spacing that Ike's been liking to use to outrange Yoshi. And you know what? I'm just going to go right where you're going to be. First of all, that up tilt hit, that was wild.
Up tilt hitting right there. Ooh, jab lock?
Jab lock. Are we going to get an up tilt? Yep, ooh, there we go. Nope. Back it up on him.
Dude, just trying to read that, but at the same time, Ike's Nair is actually really, really safe once he lands on the ground. Not a lot of people.
Oh, another jab lock. He should be dead, actually.
Yeah.
Oh, 3-1. This is not looking good
for you. You have to tech those, man. That's all I have to say. You just got to tech those. But it's so hard, especially when you're on a big stage like this, and especially when it's just so low to the ground.
Yeah. But like you said, every time Dynamite is getting that hit, he's converting off of max. And it just seems that this game, he's been getting those hits first. Let's go with that up, down tilt up air. I do like the attempt. I don't know if that's true or not, honestly. I feel like it might be.
I feel like Ike has this really huge problem with either he kills you at 60% or he will not kill you until like 200. And as you can see right over there, Ike at the end of the day would have to just use forward tilt, maybe a forward air as an edge guard.
Oh,
but again,
not that role. Ike definitely has some work to go here, but Dynamite, this is looking like his game. He is calling out Ike at every spacing. It kind of seems like he's figured out where Ike wants to be.
Really good spot dodge. Trying to get the jab lock again, but fantastic tech by Ike Tice.
Yeah, like I said, Ike does have a bit of a stepping stone to go. Dynamite doesn't really have to approach, and we're seeing Ike being forced to approach there. And every time he is, Yoshi's just hitting him with his moves. A lot of Yoshi's moves out of shield so fast.
He didn't have a double jump right there, but Dynamite swing a little bit too hard. There's a double jump armor coming in. Now you see both players playing neutral so hard. This is the strength of Yoshi just in the lead, having so many eggs to just throw, doesn't need approach.
Love that Nair fair. I was kind of expecting that backer to come out, but I think he wants to keep that fresh for when he's trying to kill. Calls him out again with that up smash. This is not looking good.
Yep. And that's a great up air. It's so hard because Ike needs to come down with the Nair all the time, so you can just wait there and anti-air. That's a super huge weakness of Ike, but that's also his strength.